would chop off the head of the losing king and parade it around, kind of nasty, but parade it around to indicate they had won. It was the trophy to say that let there be no doubt, I have won, because he is the head of the conquered king, of the defeated king. Now what happens now? So in other words, that was the conquering king's trophy. That was the conquering king's possession. It was the medal. It was the crown to say he was victorious. I got to let you know, as believers, if the world needs to know what God's best can do, all they need to be doing is looking at believers and know that we are God's trophy and we are his crown and we are his medal. So we are the ones that are on display for the world to see. And the challenge is, because now at this point, the challenge is when you can't quite tell all the ways who's in the world and who's in the word. Because now you were clear. The conquering king had the defeated king. It was clear who won. And we become the representation of what God's grace and what God's power and what God's love can do. We become the trophy. We become the crown. We become the medal. So if the world wants to know what victory looks like, all they ought to do is look at the life of a believer and say, I see victory right there. 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 And if believers don't have any joy and accept defeat, we no longer shine brightly as the trophies for the Lord. Come on, somebody. We are the visual demonstration of God's grace, his victory, his love, and mercy. And they have the conquering on this place. So let me give you this acronym we're going to look at this entire month. And this first word we're talking about is very helpful for us to kind of think about this as well. So we start talking about triumph. Here's what I want you to. So the T and the R. Actually, no, I almost stopped with these two. We're talking about transformational renewal. We start talking about triumph. Transformational renewal. Please write next to that, Romans 12:2. It says, don't be conformed to this world, but be transformed by what? The renewing of our minds. I'm going to offer, our minds have to be renewed that we are conquerors. Our minds have to be renewed that we've already won. Our minds have to be renewed that we already are more than beyond victory. So watch this, the first part. So you're going to write the word triumph out as a word here, but there's an acronym there. So what's the T and the R would be what? Transformational renewal. Here's the IU. In us, obviously renewal in us. If we become the trophies of the Lord, if we become the representations of God, this transformational renewal has to be seen in us. Now, what's going to happen? When we embrace and accept that this transformational renewal has occurred in us, what happens? At this point, making prosperity happen. Glory to God. Making prosperity happen. This transformational renewal in us, making at this point prosperity happen. Transformational renewal. This renewal that came in our minds, we are now transformed by the renewing of our minds. Transformational renewal in us, making prosperity happen. Now, let me be clear what I'm not saying, what I am saying. Prosperity is there, breakthrough is there. Blessings are there. Favor is there. We have just gotten out of position to receive it. So when my mind gets renewed and I get transformed, I'm now positioned to make, to this point, get on the path to receive what God has already done. So please read this whole thing with me with transformation. What's triumph again is what? Transformational renewal. Keep going. In us, making prosperity happen. In other words, I'm going to get on the road to my prosperity. I'm going to get on the path to my prosperity. I'm not creating the prosperity. I'm now on the road and going to get up and going to get what's already mine. I'm going to go get into the frame of this mind and get the prosperity of this mind. It's already there. I just got to be able to go and get it. So when I'm making my way, please write down Joshua 1:8. This is what I'm talking about. Joshua 1:8 says, if you want to have success, meditate on the word day and night. then you make your way prosperous. You make your way. You got to make, you had to make a decision to make your way to come through all this today. Amen, somebody. You got to make your way there. And this is what I was saying. So when my mind is renewed, this transformational renewal, and I accept the fact I no longer lose. I can't lose because I'm in Christ and he is one. And since he's one, I got to win. When I have that transformation in my mind, then I'm now making, I'm going to get on that path. I'm going to accept, I'm going to embrace, I'm going to receive the prosperity that's already mine. That I'm not creating the prosperity, but I'm now going to get on the path to make my way prosperous and get all the stuff and all the people and all the confusion and all the problems out of the way so I can get my prosperity. It doesn't matter what I'm talking about today. I'm going to move all this stuff out of the way. That there are some roadblocks in our lives on the road to our prosperity. And I'm going to make my way. I'm not going to let those obstacles stand in the way. I'm not going to let the pain stand in the way. I'm going to make my way prosperous and get to the prosperity that's already out. Say it one more time with me. What transformation means? What triumph means? It means what?
Transformational renewal
in us. Making prosperity happen. One more time. Transformational renewal in us. Making prosperity happen. One last time. Transformational renewal in us. Making prosperity happen. This is so critical right here. There has to be a transformation that occurs. That when a problem comes up, I already know God has solved. Not going to worry about it. Not going to lose sleep over it. Not going to have to take anything to go to bed at night. Not going to be up at 2 o'clock in the morning trying to see Brother Charles on TV preaching. I'm going to go ahead. This is why I'm going to go to bed and go to sleep. Because I know right now God has already worked it out. He has already moved. He has already worked it out. He's already worked it out. He's already worked it out. So at that point, I'm transformed. So if you want to see where we are on this transformational continuum, you can be saved and not transformed. Because it says be transformed by the renewal of our minds. Still going to heaven, just living in defeat. The believers, if we can confess that Jesus Christ is our personal Lord and Savior, and believe in our heart that God raised him from the dead, we are saved. But the difference between somebody who is seeing manifestation and not seeing manifestation is renewal of the mind. Transformation of the mind. The mind has been renewed. The mind has been transformed. So you see we see believers looking at the same situation. Some have peace and some are pricked. Because at that point, somebody has already decided, I know God has already worked it out. And we make it seem like people who seem like they don't have any care, something's wrong with them. No. As a believer, I got to know that God has already taken care of it. I know that God has already moved. I know that God has already worked it on my behalf. I know I got evidence. I got confidence. I'm a conqueror. I know that I win. And because I already won, I can't accept the fact. At this point, I'm just waiting for the presentation of the medal. Because I already won. Already ready. At this point, because Jesus won, and we're in Jesus, then we win. So we're just waiting for the award celebration to receive what God's already done. We see problems and think that we're defeated. We see situations and assume we've lost. There has to be a transformation. We have to have the renewal of our minds. See, the world will tell you, you don't win until you see it. Believers say, I already won because Jesus said it. Yes. Gotta have renewal of a mind. The world will say you're not healed because you still got pain in your body. The word says at this point, no, I'm just healing this pain because it's on the way out right now. And this is what I'm receiving right now because I got a renewal of my mind. I got a renewal of my mind. At this point, all you see is a closed door over here. And God has a bulldozer and knocked the wall down over here. I got to have a renewal of my mind. There has to be some transformation. And at this point, the difference between believers who are walking in victory and those who are not is about a transformation of the mind. Romans 12:2. Don't be conformed to this world. Don't be formed, fashioned by the world. Don't continue to think like the world and act like the world. But be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Transformed to see ourselves as victors and not victims. And because we are not as far along the path financially or wherever we want to be, we still have victory.
Amen.
We are in Christ. Christ has victory. We are in him, so we have victory. One last time about this triumph before we go to the next one. What is again is what? Transformational. Renewal. Where?
In us.
Doing what? Making prosperity happen. The prosperity is there. And I'm going to make my way to the prosperity. I'm not creating it, but I'm going to make my way to that prosperity. It's much like the scenario that occurred. And you all know the love story. You all know about Romeo and Juliet and all like that. But you don't know the love story of Paul and Gary Graves. That when he had a chance, when he saw her in the club, employees not supposed to be dating one another. So Brother Garrett, being on the down low, saw that woman, and the people tried to talk to him. He made his way to that woman because he said, "I gotta marry that woman. I gotta get that red bone over. I gotta make my way over there." He let anything stand in his way from getting to her. You got to make up your mind. Prosperity is there, and I'm not gonna let anything stand in my way from getting to prosperity. Is mine to break this mind. I'm not gonna let anybody or anything stand. And too often, we face a little opposition and give up. Little difficulty and give up. And the devil's like, I'm going to send my little imps out for this. I don't tell you much. But at this point, sometimes the devil got to arm himself for somebody who knows you've been transformed. And even he shows up at that point, you know, no. I'm still going to make my way to my prosperity. I'm going to make my way there. I'm not creating the prosperity. It's already been made in the name of the Lord. Now, everybody good about the transformation? I mean, about the triumph. Let's go back. Now, we'll go back and take a look at more of the definitions later on this month and maybe on Tuesday as well. Now, significant. When you hear the word significant, what do you normally think about significant?
Important.
Important, that's good, significant. So at this point, you know, and nowadays talk about, you know, now policies are gone for husbands and wives and significant others. But the idea was it's significant, so significant. So let's look at what the Bible has to say about significance. Okay, I'm not talking about some man-made law. I'm talking about what the Word has to say about significance. So significance. Now here's what I want to offer. There can often be kind of a vertex where we have to make a decision to go forth and either be successful or significant. Oftentimes, we stand there, and a lot of people focus on the success part, but it's not on the significant part. I'm gonna give you what it means definition in just a moment. Are you with what I'm saying? There are a lot of people that spend their life and their time trying to be successful, but don't even think about how they can end up being significant. So at this vertex, at this crossroads, too many people have taken the road for success and that not working out well. And rather than saying at this point, it's more important to be significant than successful. Now, can you be both? Yeah. But the fact is that there's a vertex there. It ought to be about being significant versus being successful. Let's talk about what this means in particular. So read, if you all can read this, read this with me. Success is overrated. Strive for significance. Now, still, this is building up our definition now, anticipation about what this means. So, significant means making a difference. It means making a difference. That's what it comes from the Greek word. It means making a difference. Significant, making a difference. But secondly, watch what it also. I love this next one. It means also providing the advantage. So we are significant. We are helping somebody gain the advantage they would not have had. When we're being significant, we're making a difference in somebody else's life. And so the point now, what's the first one? The definition of the first one is what? Significant what?
Making
a difference, but also what? Providing the advantage. In other words, because we have been in their lives, they now have an advantage they didn't have before. Because we've been in their lives, a difference has been made. So now we get ready to go back and have this focus of success versus significance. No, got to live a life of significance to make a difference in somebody else's life, and also at that point give them the advantage. Everything we come out here, every time we come on Tuesdays and Sundays, to try to give everybody the advantage, because we know we've already won. And everything we know to give you, we're going to give you, because we know that God has already